spirits using like two of you. You see, you guys with me so far?
Mm-hmm.
What I want to do is aim for, if you look at planar mirror, imagine the eye is closed, and I'm going to aim for the bottom of the ball and the lid. Because it's not just a ball, but it's sitting inside a lid. We call it a shelf. So aim for the ball and the shelf.
Aim for a ball and a shelf.
So here's a teardrop here.
Chris,
yeah.
What's that line on the nose that you drew, the second one?
This one?
Yeah.
That's the where it changes the bottom plane.
Oh, what's below it? Oh, just do two.
Yeah, we'll get that in a second.
Oh.
So I think I've been telling you a lot of these too. Once you get the eye and the ball, just mass it in like this, just to simplify it. In general, it will be darker than the rest of the face, even though a lot of things look really bright, especially highlights. It only looks bright relative to all the darks around it. So it's just an optical illusion in most cases. So one thing I like to do with eyes is because these spheres and ellipses are really hard to draw, especially if you're new to drawing undercut. It's going to be really hard. I like to box it up. Actually, Kevin Chen taught me this. This is pretty sweet. What I do is take the tear duct. Here's our center. Bring it up. Start thinking of a hexagon. And this point is the top of the shelf. Can someone hand me a point man, please? I'm going to draw a little hexagon, right? What I'm looking for, thank you, is this guy right here.
Don't they call that an epicanthal fold?
Huh?
Isn't that called an epicanthal fold?
Yeah, maybe. Probably. You can look that up. Looking here, looking at the bottom here for this structure. Here it's bisected and it's a hexagon. Next, I'm going to either do a cylinder like this, round it off, or if you're not comfortable yet, continue to do with your straights. And that's pretty much it. What I'm really interested in is not how perfect you render your eye at this point. I want you to think planarly. I want you to think top plane of the eye, bottom plane of the eye, two side planes. I want you to use your tones here. Because once you think planarly, then all the lighting shading is a piece of cake. So this is, imagine a model with eyes closed here. What I want to do now is start to cut away the opening. And the top lid sits over the bottom lid. So it'll come out a little bit. It's actually more accurate. The bottom lid has a bite on it. And to draw an eye, I'm also going to box it up. What you can do, you can wrap it up too. I like the box because it reinforces this movement. It's really simple plane statement. It's easier to draw. This is our iris. Is that pupil? What is pupil?
Iris.
Iris. This is pupil there.
Yeah.
So even the highlight, take it over and box that up too. Now your lid will cast a shadow. And the bottom lid will be slightly darker. And here at the ends, here, and so this is the closest of our boxy eye. And again, you don't have to box it up at all. If you are comfortable doing your C's, you know, get yourself out. As long as your planes look pretty solid on the happy camper. And your overlaps on the right. But for now, you know, let's think with straights. Just for now. You guys with me?
Yeah.
Makes sense. And if you get stuck, you can grab Planar Man. I look at him all the time. This will really be helpful once we get to the shading. So let's do those.